Hello out there, and welcome back to the sixth episode of my Let's Play Minecraft series. In the last episode, we started our base, which was a new segment to the series. We also started the gold farm, and we made a cool tool shop. And in between the last episode and this one, I finished the layer of the gold farm on top of the nether, and I also actually extended this shop. So we now have something upstairs, which is we have swords, and we have silk touch pickaxes, and we have fortune pickaxes. These are pretty popular. Yeah, so that's what's been going on between this episode and the last one. I also built walls on the base that we started. So now in between the towers, there's all walls. I didn't finish the roof. And I didn't continue working much on it because I wanted you guys to join me. I want to start this episode off, as we did the previous ones, by just making some adjustments to the skeleton farm. So let me just grab some resources here. Like this. And at this point you might have guessed what we're gonna do. Because we recently got an iron shop in the city. And I'm gonna show you that when we do the city tour. And with an iron shop, it's actually possible to do a lot of cool things, a lot of cool automation. So the first thing that I really want to do is make this thing sort its items automatically. So we're going to put an item sorter here, and we're going to do an expandable version of it that I always like to use, which instead of just being able to put one chest, you can actually stack them on top of each other, making it more bulk storage friendly. Yeah, so let's just see how much space we need here. We want the hopper line to go across the top here. It's not going to be very long, right? It's going to be, whoops, something close to that. And then this hopper will also point into this chain. And so we need to remove this in order to gain access. So, beneath these hoppers, we want a layer of hoppers facing into nothing. And these will be the filter hoppers. So if I just place some blocks all along here, we can have some hoppers here pointing into that block. And then below that, we can actually put our chest. So the chest will go here, and then this is very difficult to illustrate with all of this in the way. You'll have a hopper pointing into that chest, a hopper above that pointing into nothing, and then the items will go into here. And we need some redstone. So right now, this hopper will suck everything up that goes into this one. And we don't want that happening. So we need to actually lock this hopper. And we can do that with some redstone. So let's make some space back here. And just build one of them, and then I'll copy it along to the others. So first we need to read the output of this hopper, if there's something in it that's important. How many things are in it. And we do that, of course, with a comparator. So let's just get the comparator. This will take the output of the inventory behind the block, right? So it's this one's inventory. And then this will go into two redstone dust, which we have here, and one there. This will then be picked up by a repeater, and then go into this block. And on this block, there will be a redstone torch. There, and that signal will be picked up by this block here. So it's actually this block here which is locking this hopper from sucking up items from this one. So if there are not enough items in this one will be locked and nothing will go past it. And we can see here, if we put in 24 items, this will drop down to 22, and then it will stop, because the signal here only goes down one. And that's not enough to turn off this torch down here. So this is being powered, and it will hold one, but then the rest of the items will go in here. And so in our case, that will probably be like bones. And so we can actually put 21 items here, and then we can put bones in. And now there will only stay one bone in this hopper once it's done, and the rest of them will filter directly into here, which is exactly what we want. So we just need a couple more of these modules, and I'm just going to plop them down really quick. We actually only have arrows and bones and then things that we can't sort because they don't stack. So we don't need we actually only need two of those. The reason I like this design is you can actually put a hopper and another chest below and below and below and just go deeper and deeper with no change to the redstone whatsoever. So I really like that feature. It's a nice version of the item filter. Like this. And we need that one. This here and this here. And yeah, that's it. Oh, we also need these two blocks. Then the hoppers. Hopper, hopper. A hopper above that. Going there. For this one, we just wanted to go directly into a chest, so we will just do no redstone behind it and just close it off like that. So it looks nice like that. Let's put a torch so it's not all dark. And then this one we don't need. Yeah, so now we can just put our torches here, or our chests here. Chest, regular chest, and I need a trap chest. I didn't bring one. I forgot. And then we can put in, you know, 21 stone here. Oop. Like this, and then some arrows. There. And then these will filter into currently just this hopper, but into the chest when we get a chest there. So that's pretty much what we want. I also need to flip the direction of that one. Let's just kill all of these off. We can actually make it stay up longer by doing that, so that is not a problem. I have an extra hopper right there. And we got the carpet back, so let's just put that in place. There's a bit of lag on the server, as you can see. A bit annoying, but there's not much we can do about that. Oh, that's a problem. Why did it swallow the stones? Oh, yeah, because we put in a whole stack of items. So this is not very good with the... If you give it too many items in here, it'll sort of mess up. So you have to input your items somewhere before the actual filtering starts. Otherwise, it may break, as you just saw. So now it should work all the time. And let's just give ourselves a bit of space to walk back here. And yeah, that's the change for this video. This is more or less how you'll remember the castle base thing. I did change the towers a little. I put in these archer holes where people can stand inside and shoot out of. And in this episode, I thought we'd do some, you know, just some prettying up, putting in some little detailing work, and also finishing the top, because currently it just looks silly on the top, right? It's just all flat. Let me just show you how it looks and feels inside right now, because that has changed quite a bit. This is now how big it's gonna be, and I put in sort of these guidelines for flooring. I think I'm gonna lower the floor a bit and then maybe not have a story there to make this bottom layer of floors be very tall and have some more mobility in them. Currently, the only tower you can actually use to traverse things is this one. And here's one of the shooting holes. And These holes in the walls are also for shooting out people who approach that you don't want coming inside. Yeah, it looks pretty nice in here. I like the size. I like the feel of it. And now we just like to go and put some more details on it. I like to use netherrack for scaffolding. I think I heard it on Tango's channel. He did it a lot. It really stands out in a build like this that's mostly gray. You can see, oh, I forgot to remove some scaffolding. There's netherrack. That needs to be upside down one and an upside down one over here. No. Over here. And then maybe with some fences. That looks pretty good. Yeah, so I'll just be doing some little changes like that. And I think I'm just gonna do an etho cut. Now that I've pretty much settled on a style, I want to show you how I built these top towers if you're curious or if you want to follow along. So the first thing I do is I raise them up a bit. A little bit of lag there. I raise them up 2 blocks and then they need to extend a bit further so that this space up here is a bit larger than what you'd usually have. So I add a block like around there and in the middle and then on the corners and then on the middle and in the corners, on the middle, the corners, in the middle over here. And now I add a trim of slabs around that all the way around. This. And now I build up the wall so that it's so we don't fall out accidentally. Like this. I put the slabs on top to make the notches. And now I take the fences here and put them on the edge to make the colors vary a bit. And then I put torches on those so that we have some light up here, which I think looks pretty nice. And over there. And the last one. Like this. And finally, the last thing I do is I just go around here and I add like some detail or some depth to it by making this stick out a bit with some upside down stairs. I also need to add those on the outside of the castle, but I haven't built the scaffolding and stuff for that. I'll do that later. But yeah, that's all for towers done. Currently we can't actually get in here, but I think I'm just gonna add a door probably here or maybe over here actually. Yeah, somewhere around there I'll build a door so we can get in here. Yeah, that's the towers and the top of the roof done. Or not done, I mean we have a level deal so we can build something up here. To make it a bit more interesting. Currently, if you get up here to 2 players, PvP won't be very interesting because it's just a large flat area. I want to build like a big obstacle here in the middle that you can run around, maybe get up into and stuff. But that will be for another time, maybe in between episodes. But yeah, so that's pretty much the finish of the... around. Let's just have a look from a bit of afar. I think it looks nice. I like it. It has some depth and some stuff. We might go up here and add some detail up here because that looks a bit flat. So I'll just go and do that now. And here we are. That made a lot of difference, I think. I just pulled out the top thing, the top block one. So now the roof is also a little bit larger, which might be nice, as we have a bit more space to work with, and then put in some fences to sort of give it some contrast. Yeah, that's all we're gonna do for the base in this episode. We'll return to that, of course, in the next one. For now, let's go to the farm. So today we're gonna extend this farm that we started last time, and we're gonna get to the very exciting job of building the first spawnable donut. And you can see I already placed some stone brick here at the right height, so we don't need to measure that out. And let's see if I can actually get on it. I'm on it, yes. So you can see zombie pikmin can spawn here. This is too high, so they can spawn, and ghasts can't spawn. We don't want ghasts at all up here, and that's also why I've kept this line here to make ghasts not spawn here. Ghasts are 3 blocks high. So what we're gonna do today is I'm gonna just go around down here, 2 blocks below, and then trace the exact same donut that we have above. Like this. And then we're gonna fill it all in, and then we're gonna have 2 of our 4 donuts. So I'm gonna do this and enjoy this time lapse. So now it's time to actually tour the city and see all the things that happened since we last did a tour, which I think was in the first episode or something. So the first shop we get to right when we get into the city is the spruce shop. And I thought a good way to show off the shops was to purchase one thing from every shop. And you can see I brought a little shulker handbag here. So we are going to put all the things in there. So this is the spruce shop, the first shop I think we got. It's right at the entrance to the city. We also actually just recently got all these street lights. They turn off on at night, so that's really nice. This very Achacha looking building right here is the iron shop. Below here we can purchase iron blocks, which we are just gonna do here. Put them in our shulker handbag. And upstairs, we can purchase pistons, or anvils, or hoppers. Yeah, it's very cheap, so that's nice. Let's just see if we can get out here. So, the second thing we get to is not really that new. It's the city hall, where we purchase all of our shop licenses. Right in here. Ooh, a lot of people purchased. And we can also purchase patents, and we can trademark items, which we've actually done. Nobody else can make food stamps. We could also apply for changes to the city by putting a book in there. The third thing, or fourth, is our cool tool shop. And we are actually very familiar with that, because we built this. Well, let's just go in here. We won't purchase anything in here because it's our own shop. We'll just check. Yeah, well, we got some decent sales. Nice. let's continue here. Over on the other side, besides the iron shop, we have another of our own shops. We have the meat farm, or the butcher shop. Whoa. We need to restock this very soon. I did not know this was sold out. But that's really nice. We made a lot of sales. If we continue here, on our right, we have the torch shop. And we are actually a very frequent buyer of this in already. But let's just make another purchase. Like this. Put it in our handbag. This was also one of the first shops we got. Maybe that actually was before the spruce shop. Very nice shop. On the left, we have an ice shop, or packed ice shop. So you can see we can buy a stack of packed ice for one diamond, which is a nice price. Yeah, I don't think this shop sells anything else at the moment. Maybe it will later. Let's just check up here. Yeah, there's nothing up here. Good. If we continue down here, we have our own super smelter shop, where you put the items in here, you pay in here, and then your items pop out in front of the furnace, cooked or smelted. So that's really nice. Over here, if we continue, there's actually a path down here. And there are plans to extend the city in that direction, but there are no plots yet, so nobody has built out there, so we won't go. Over here we have the first shop that we built. It's a soup kitchen shop, where you can go and purchase these food stamps, and each food stamp will then give you 8 soups. And you can also throw out trash in here. And talking about trash, I actually wanted on this tour to just every so often just put down some trash cans. So I brought the resources to actually make that happen. So let's put in some trash cans. We put in a chest with a hopper on top. In order to get access to this, we also put a stair down there. So now we can open the chest. And then we just place... This is too deep. Oh, I should have brought an axe. Maybe it's just really laggy right now. Yeah, it is. Come on. Like this, so let's build that again. Sorry. We have this right there. We have this, so now we can open the chest to empty it. And then on top of this, we just put a cauldron. It's very similar to the trash can we built in there. And so the rule is, anybody can come around here and throw anything out. It'll go down into the trash can and then into the thing below. If you remove the block in front and open up so you can look inside it, you have to empty it. That'll be the rule. So it's a community thing, right? We all have to empty it once in a while. And I think maybe we shouldn't touch other people's plots, so we'll just put one down here. Also, with a chest and a stair and a hopper right there, and then some dirt right there. Oh, yeah, and the cauldron, of course. Like that. Let's also build one over at this shop, if there's space. Well, where can we make it fit? Right here, maybe? Yeah, that'll be okay. Yeah. Let's remove that, put in this. Or maybe we want to raise it a bit. No, because then the road, it won't look nice. This will be fine. If we put the stair like that, we can't actually access the chest because the hopper takes up the full block. Even though it doesn't really take up a full block. But it sort of does. Yeah, so let's get back to the... maybe we should just put one back at the entrance. Maybe we should put it right next to this one. That makes sense, right? So we put a chest with a hopper on the stairs. Not facing that way. Some stairs with some dirt and a cauldron. And finally, let's just put it out here because I know At some point there'll be an ender chest right there, so we'll just prepare for that by putting a trash can already. Yes, perfect. So let's get back to the tour. Catching up here. Yeah, here we are. So if we continue, on our left here we have a sand and glass shop that's doing very well. Oh, maybe this means we can't go inside. I think it's also supposed to sell sand, but it's not quite open yet. It's a very, very large build. If we go in here on the left, we can go upstairs and we have a quartz, nether quartz and magma block shop, which is also looking very cozy. I think this is the bone block, yeah. Very nice build. Maybe we should just put... No, we'll get... This is also another one of our shops. This is the leather shop, where we can go inside and we can purchase item frames and books and leather and saddles now. And downstairs here we have a bed area for guests. If you're in the city and it's night, a lot of people actually use that to make it day. And I think this is also our plot, so let's just put in a trash can here. Like this. Yes. Leather shops go up there. That looks good. So if we continue around here, we get back to the center with the city hall. But there's actually a small shop crammed right in here, and that is the cactus shop. You will remember that cactus is actually free out in the mining area, farming area, but to be true to our little rule, oh, we forgot to purchase. Oh no, we forgot a lot of shops to purchase stuff. Let's just go back and purchase something here. We need to purchase a stack of glass. And we also need to purchase... I think we only need to purchase one thing from each shop. So let's purchase the magma blocks, because I don't think I have any of those. Let's put those things in our chalker bag. Good. So the next shop here is this smithy or weapon shop, or I don't know what you'd call it. In here we can purchase all sorts of tools. We have diamond pickaxes for 2 diamonds, or diamond armor for 3 diamonds, swords for 1 diamond, oh I guess they're sold out, and 2 diamonds for axes, which is a really good price. I think, well, we have elytra, so we don't really need armor. I think we're gonna buy a pickaxe. Let's do it like this. Nice little build. In here we have a shop that I've used quite a lot in making the cool tool shop. Here we can purchase books. All sorts of books. We can purchase mending, efficiency, depth strider. Ooh, there's one depth strider. We will take that. That's a nice book to have. Looting, feather falling, all sorts of books. And so I came here and I purchased a lot of things, and then we made the cool tools, and then we're selling them over there for about the same price. Let's just put that away. Good. Over here we have sort of an area we've never really been to, and it's the swampy shops. It's a duet of shops, I guess you could say. And here we can purchase slime balls. I love this swampy area. I mean, it's such a great idea to make a swamp. And yeah, you can see this is called the Swamped. Up here we have a witch shop that somebody's built. This wasn't here naturally, of course. And in here we can buy all sorts of things from witches. Let's just purchase this because I think it's a really good price. And they also have a pay what you want section, which is funny. Oh, I guess it's turning night. Let's just look at the last part of the city. So over here we just added a bridge, which is very nice. And you can go to the other side to find a new district that we're going to build over here. This district is going to have some different lamps and maybe a few other things being a little bit different. But we'll get back to this area later in this episode. I think that's actually everything for the city. Let's just plop in another trash can in this area here. Even though we don't have a shop, I guess we'll just do it on the edge of somewhere else. Let's do it right here. I don't think that will be too much in the way. Like this. Oh, the stair. Ah, it's not perfect. Like that. So now we have trash cans spread all around the city, which is nice. And yeah, we've seen everything there is to see in the city. One thing that I did actually also want to do while we were in the city is to build a small public service announcement or message board area thing. So let's just purchase a shop license. I guess we don't really need to purchase a shop license because it's not really a shop. But I think this is a good area. It's sort of an intersection. I think a lot of people go through here. So let's just take down some of these trees. And then we'll build like our message board right around here. Let's put it right in the center here. So what I'm imagining is sort of a 4x4 thing with, let's just put in some stone. And maybe it would be nice if you could go all the way around, but I mean, it's not really possible with the current squares or areas in the city. Should we move that forward? Yeah, we should move that forward. Let's go out to here and then not take this one. And then I'm thinking probably put some cobblestone walls maybe there. Here, and then, oh, not stairs, and then with some cobblestone on top. Like this, and some stairs. I did not bring enough stairs. Let's put them. Is that good? I think that's fine. Some more, yeah, we can craft some if we need to. Yeah, so the messages are gonna be on signposts on these. Maybe we should actually flip them. I think that'll be better. So that they're upside downstairs. Like this. Not like that. That, and we need to get on top of that now. And up here, I think we want to go just with some spruce half slabs. Or maybe we actually want to go up a little bit and then add another layer of stairs. So something that we're always missing when we're in the city is sort of crafting benches. So I thought we could put like some in the middle here so that people always have some crafting tables. Right, let's get down again to place the stairs like this. And it might actually look good with slabs out here instead, like this. Sort of breaking it up so that it's not just a big cobble thing. Cobble is not the prettiest texture. Put one there, and then on the cobble. Yeah, oh, this, and then there's the crafting table in the middle, and let's just go on top again. Yeah, and so up here I think we should actually place, just put in some a small roof. Maybe we should do that with stairs as well, to give it a little more depth, or a little more height, I guess you would say. So we just put in one stair, then we need to have the other one facing the other way, then have this one facing that way, and this one facing that way, giving us this nice little, it looks like we have two levels, but we actually don't. So let's go down, remove that leaf, and then now just make this here a little more accessible maybe. And then we can put news here on these, so we can say we now have a message board. Which is a news itself. So let's just place some empty signs so people can put things on it. Yeah. And it's the message board. Oh, maybe we should put in some lighting. Even though there's a lamp right next to it, I think it might look good if we put in some more contrast here. These, let's get out our torches. Nope. Like that. That looks pretty good. Now, we're in the farming area, and that's because I actually want to build a small bonus farm. It's not really a farm, so I hesitate to call it a farm, but it's something that will place out here, and it's connected to the trash cans that we just did. So we're going to build an incinerator, or whatever you call something like this. It's going to destroy items, and it's for when we actually empty out the trash cans, we want to have some place to just throw them out forever, right? They should just go away. And so we're gonna use a very, very, we're gonna try to make this very, very fast. And the way we're gonna do that is by having some burnout clocks. So some of you might know this. If we place a torch down there, and then that torch will power this block, which will then power this redstone, which turns off this redstone torch. If we don't have this here, it will actually burn out. Right now it won't turn on again until we give it like an update, and then it'll flash like 7 times or so, and then it'll be turned off again. We don't want this incinerator to turn off. We do want it to keep going, so we can place 2 torches, and now it'll keep flashing indefinitely. And so we can put that over there, meaning we have a very, very fast pulse. Very, very fast. And for now, we just want to turn it off, because we only want it on when there's items in here. Yeah, so this shot out 2 times more than necessary, but that's perfectly acceptable. It shoots out the items very fast. I think it's the fastest way to actually pulse in Minecraft. And we also want some way to put in the items into the dropper here, because we don't really want access directly to this. What we want to do is we want to place some trapped chests right here. And the reason we have trapped chests is that if you accidentally you're throwing out items, it's like, oh, sorry, I didn't actually mean to put those items in there. And then when you close it, this will start punching out the items. Of course, currently there is no reason to have a very fast clock here, because the items will be limited in speed by this hopper. But I have an idea to sort of get around that at some point. But yeah, we're not gonna do that right now. What we are gonna do is put in lava here and then place in a block above the lava so nobody accidentally falls in. And now it's done. We can actually destroy items. So when you empty a trash can in the city, you can just go out here, put them all in here, and then they'll be destroyed automatically, which is a nice touch. I also am thinking about building some of these near to our some of our farms, like the Enderman farm, because we have so many Ender pearls, and we don't want them just lying on the ground, and we don't want to manually throw them over the edge. So maybe building one of these to throw them out would be smart. But I'm considering that. Yeah, so that was just a little bonus farm. And now on to the next order of business. And now it's time for the final part of this episode. We are gonna build a shop, of course. So let's start by purchasing another plot. I actually did find a way to make this message board into a mini shop thing. Now you can purchase commercials for one diamond, and therefore we needed the shop license. So I'm gonna probably make use of that in a moment when we build this new shop. So it's gonna be in the new district, both to draw people over here, but also to get it started. The new district is a bit more expensive. As you could see, I purchased this plot here for 8 diamonds, and I think it's to make this area over here a bit more exclusive, which I like. I also like being the first to move in here. So what we're gonna build is of course a wood shop, because we've been farming wood in between the last couple of episodes, and that has been leading up to this. So let me just lay down the foundation. I'm thinking it'll be something like the door will be right there, and then we'll have some small wooden structure here. Let's see if we can make this happen. And there, and then over here. Leaves are in the way. That's a problem when you're building with wood, right? The leaves don't really despawn. No, that shouldn't go there. There, and then around. And then I have a funny idea, right? This shop is gonna sell spruce and oak. And so I want to try to mix these in a sort of a silly way, right? I want both of them in the build, and I don't know if they go well together. I just think it looks a bit fun. It's funny to make. Let's make this one point in the same direction. That other one here. It's gonna be a very quick shop, I expect. Over here, be a vertical column, vertical, vertical. This. Let's see, yes. Like that. I didn't bring windows. I should have brought some windows. We'll have windows there. And we'll then mirror that over here. Which should be like this. Yeah, we need this one being. This one being there. Also on that one. And then that's gonna be sort of the foundation for what we're building. We want the floor down here. And over here, I want something that looks possibly a bit silly. I want like this, like this. This is gonna be underground, so let's do it like that. Can we do this? Oh, we might need that one for later. And then here I want birch in between them, like that. And then on top of that, we want to do a similar thing but with the birch, right? So you could really see it from all angles when you're considering to buy it. And just one more layer there, like that. The last one might be a bit tricky. Yeah, so that's sort of the sample wall. You can see how they fit together and how they mix, and that's pretty nice. We also want a different floor here. So I'm thinking the floor will do sort of in spruce mostly, and then use the floor colors to show where you can purchase either oak or birch. So in the middle here, I think it'll just be spruce. Of course, this shop actually means we're in competition with the spruce shop, but I think we can outsell him. And then over here, I'm gonna sell birch. Oh, like this. And over in the other side, we're gonna sell oak. Let's just plop down some chests. Like that. Maybe this should be switched out. Not completely sure. But we also need to put in a lock over the door. I forgot to bring a door. Like that. Okay, it's looking good. It's looking pretty nice. And for the roof, I wanted, oh, we don't have a crafting table over here. Let's just put one right in the floor. Because it's very far to the nearest other shop when you're over here. Obviously, I have to go there now because it's turning night. But usually, if you're in that area, you might just want a crafting bench right away. And so that's why we put it down anyway. Let's see if we can. Yeah, so for the roof, I'm thinking we do oak slabs, because sort of the most of the build is made from wood, so I thought, why not make the roof from stone instead. I should probably get up there so it's a bit more easy to build. And then we'll remove these leaves while we're at it. There and there. And go out there. You should almost always make your roof extend one block further than the walls. That gives it like a nice feel of depth. Otherwise it gets that same feeling that Minecraft standard villages have. They're very flat, they're sort of boring. Very interesting to look at. So building one over the edge really helps with that. Oh, did I do that wrong? No. No, that's fine. Yeah, and then we're just gonna do a regular old lab roof here. Roofs are super difficult, I find. Go down there. We need to remove those logs. We can do that later. A bunch of slabs here. It should go up. Pretty sure. Go out and go there. Yeah, I think this is coming together pretty nice. Maybe we should put a chimney up here. But on the other hand, it's sort of made of wood, so fire won't really be an option anywhere close to this shop. So we can't really do that. Let's remove that, and let's also go back here and remove temporary wooden things. So. This one, I'm gonna put in some windows over there and a door over here when I have a door. I want the spruce door, I really like those, so I'm gonna hold out until I have a spruce door with me. Let's see, can we make that look nice? Really, we'll just plop down some dirt there. Again, not there. In there, so that it looks a little bit supported. And yeah, that's the shop. Let's just stock it with whatever we've got. So the other shop sells at 32 per diamond, so I think I'm gonna start at the same price. We might lower this when we get more stock, but for now I think that'll do fine, and we won't be too much in competition. It'll only be the people coming over here because they like this color of wood better, or if they need it for something specific. So we won't step too much on the other guy's toes there. Yeah, and I'm also gonna plant some trees or flowers or something to make this nice down here, because now we just have this open area, which is not too good. But yeah. That's actually a finished shop right there. No cutting at all. Oh, almost no cutting. So, that will be it for this episode. Thank you very much for watching, and hopefully see you back later. Bye.